what is a content management system? Whereas before you had a program running on your desktop and you were downloading and uploading HTML files, the content management system, or CMS, runs on the server and keeps all pages in a database. This means you don't need a program installed on your computer. You can edit web pages anytime, anywhere. Plus, I think that you'll find editing within the CMS is a lot easier than in Dreamweaver. There are some differences you should know about. Pages created in the CMS are published by default, but when you're editing a page, you can change its status to draft. Then, when you save the page, you can see exactly how it will look and make additional edits if necessary. Meanwhile, the public still sees your last published version. WYSIWYG, or what you see is what you get, is what we call a class of editors like Dreamweaver and Word that are supposed to show you how your final web page will look, but seldom do. Instead, in the CMS, we're using a plain text filter called TextStyle that takes in simple formatting and outputs HTML code. It's easy to learn and there's a toolbar to help out. After a while, you probably won't use the toolbar at all because it's faster just to type your text with the formatting already in it. TextStyle saves you from having to know HTML, but sometimes we do need to use it in a page. When you encounter HTML, take some time to try to understand what it does, but don't worry about it if you don't. In all cases, just leave it alone. Similar to HTML tags are radius tags. They start with an R and a colon, and they do things with the CMS, like looping over child pages, or inserting content from other pages or other parts of the same page. They can be used for inserting protected email addresses or attached images. We'll show you all that later. So, to review, a content management system is a program that runs on the server, not on your computer, and that means you don't have to install it and it's accessible from anywhere in the world that you have an internet connection. I think you'll find once you start using it that it's simpler to use than many desktop HTML programs. One of the things that the content management system gives us is the ability to create drafts. If you're working on a page and you don't want to make those changes visible, you can save the page as a draft, and then you can see exactly how it will look, but the general public still sees it as it was when you last published it. Then once you're ready to make your changes live, you can save it as published, and the public will see your changes. TextStyle formatting is the way of adding headings and lists and links and so forth. It's not a what you see is what you get interface like you might get with Dreamweaver or with Microsoft Word. Instead, it's just a simple system of formatting that's then converted to HTML. HTML is, of course, the language that web browsers understand to build a web page. You don't need to know all of the formatting. If you forget, there's a toolbar to help you remember, but again, after a while, you'll probably get to where you don't need to use the toolbar. As I mentioned, HTML is the language web browsers understand. We'll use it for more complex situations where TextStyle just won't do the job. When you encounter it, don't feel like you need to learn it, and you don't necessarily need to understand what's going on. But when you encounter it in your pages, just try to understand what it's doing and work around it and move on. You will eventually want to know about radius tags. Those are used for manipulating content in the content management system. They do things like looping over child pages, inserting content from that page or another page, protecting email addresses, and inserting or linking to attachments. You'll learn more about these later. So if you don't gain anything else from this presentation, just understand that a content management system keeps our web content organized and under control.